Welcome back, everybody. Today we are going to make a Bluetooth control RC airboat. Now she's ready to see the water, so let's go for a ride. Let's go. Hi guys, this is my Bluetooth RC Android app, specially designed for RC boats, cars, like that. And it's automatically connected to my boat. I'm pretty happy with that. Let's do some throttle tests. Start with 3%, 10, oh my god, this feels good, 20, oh my god, 40, this feels good. This is amazing! Okay guys, now we have the hull and a bunch of batteries, and this is a fully functional Bluetooth RC receiver, totally designed and built at home, and it's working great. Guys, probably you might think that this is not the same motherboard that we saw in the beginning of this video, but that's not true. This is the same board, but I did some changes to make the system more stable. So what I did here, I just optimized the firmware to the 8 MHz internal clock to get this wider working voltage range and keep the chip in a safe operating area. As a result, now we are running this in an internal oscillator, so we don't need that external crystal and supporting components anymore. And I added an additional decoupling cap in the power rail to compensate the voltage dips. Now the circuit is totally stable, and this is a stable version of the circuit. Let's just talk about the cockpit of our board. We have a beautiful looking seat, steering lever, tachometer, speedometer, and a gas pedal. It's just awesome. This is not the thing that I want to mention here. I just added some neodymium magnets on the corners of this pyroplastic sheet as well as the back of them. And I did the same in the corners of this hull as well. And if you want to close this, just touch down, boom. It's magnetic, bro. Let's talk about the working of the board. How does it work? It's working with the principle of differential thrust. And what I mean by that, let's picture this. Here we have two motors. One is in the left and one is in the right. Think about it. If we're running these two motors at the same speed, both will produce equal amount of thrust, and which pushes the air equally backward, which makes the board move forward. Then how does the board make turns? Which is pretty easy than you think. If you want to make a left turn, then you want to slow down the left motor, so the thrust from the left side is weaker than the right side. So the right side pushes more than the left side, which makes the left turn. If you want to make a right turn, then you want to slow down the right motor, so the thrust from the right side is weaker than the left side. So the left side pushes more than the right, which will make the right turn. And we can always control the turning angle by the amount of thrust difference that we made. Let's wire the circuit board to our board, which is really simple because it doesn't have tons and tons of connectors. Here's only two connectors, one for the battery and one for the motor. We already soldered the motors to a 4-pin header. On the header, the left two goes to the left motor and the right two goes to the right motor, which is the same on the PCB too. So just plug the connector to the PCB, we're done. We connected the left to the left motor and right to the right motor. And plug the battery on the battery connector. Top one is the positive, bottom one is the negative. Then use a double-sided tape and tape this circuit board and the battery in the hull. Boom. Now what? Close this hull with the beautiful magnetic cockpit. We done. What else? Let's put this baby on the water.